Welcome to Ottawa, a night that could see the Senators move into first place in the Atlantic Division. But to do it, they'll have to beat the Chicago Blackhawks, the top team in the Western Conference, who have won 9 of their last 10 games on the road. Keith up ahead for Taves. The Chicago captain plays it across for Panarin. As Chicago is changing, Panarin pokes it back. Keith, a long shot. Condon pokes it away.
It's a nifty little backhand saucer play by Jonathan Taves in the neutral zone. Panarin stops up, gets back to the point. Clear lane for Mike Condon. Little trouble corralling the rebound, but it gets skated out of harm's way. Senators very aggressive in the neutral zone, trying to hold the line. Don't allow Chicago to get set up.
Jumping in is Schmaltz. He gets loose in front. Schmaltz, a backhand shot stopped in tight by Condon. What a stop again by Mike Condon as he turns away Nick Schmaltz on the power play.
What an unreal stop by Mike Condon. And it just to talked about aggressiveness in the neutral zone, and it comes back to bite you as Schmaltz walks right through. Schmaltz just changes his angle and tries to go backhand five hole on Condon. Good read, paddle down.
Won the championship and allegedly stole the trophy. Smith with a quick shot, and Darling turns that away. Burrows spins and fires. Darling makes the save, end of the rebound. Turns away Brassard, and then buried in front.
That's the advantage of being 6 foot six in net. You can lay on your stomach and extend your legs and take away the ice.
He spins back as Ottawa begins a change.
Chances at both ends, Gord, as the...
Well, look out. Brassard with a red on goal. Now Panera with a chance. And Condon makes the save there. The first on his teammate. The second on Panera.
Just an errant puck bouncing. He tries to throw it behind the net, and it bounces off the side of the net. Panera controls the rolling puck, and Condon alertly rips it out of the air.
But it remains 0-0. In comes Panera. Drops it back. Van Riemsdyker shot. Condon makes the stop. Now Oduya slaps it down. Panarin tapped that wide of the goal. Knocked down by Turris. His centering pass kicked back by Ryan, but Hossa picks it off. Now knocked down by Weidman. In shoots, and Darling gets a piece of that.
Weidman takes a little bit of ice for himself. There's a screen in front. Bobby Ryan actually goes across the sight line of Scott Darling.
And as Engel comes in, but he's shielded off there by Kruger. Hoffman's pass picked off by Terrace. Brought in now by Hossa. In shoots, knocked down by Condon. Loose puck for Hossa. Backhand shot, and Condon got a piece of that. While the third period heroics by Condon were the difference to get a point against Tampa the other night. And he makes a terrific pair of saves there on Marian Hossa in tight.
It's a one-on-one situation on Fanouf. He fires it around him. Condon doesn't get a clean grab, but he goes towards the puck and gets enough of it with his glove as Hossa tries to outweigh him and change his angle right there.
Or the trick door in Buffalo.
I was just going to say, where you get the Zamboni driver.
Yeah, put his foot out against the door and create a seam as Weidman shoots at the goalpost. Weidman pounded off the pipe. It goes back into Darling, and he hangs on. Oh, what a chance there for Chris Weidman to break this game open as he rings it off the pipe, and it stays out.
The bounce off the boards. Chris Weidman, short side, as Wingles is right in front of Scott Darling. Darling doesn't track it. It hits the short side post and bounces right in between his legs.
Panarin works across the top, feeds across. Keith the drive. Condon pad save. He's down. Rebound. They battle away and score. Nick Schmaltz pokes it home. And the Hawks have taken the lead with 11:56 to go.
Condon with the initial offering, and then see Mark Mathot try to push it underneath Mike Condon, and at the last second it's poked underneath the outstretched glove of Mike Condon.
So the puck is clearly in.
Yeah.
The question is, was Condon interfered with before the puck went in?
After review, the call on the ice stands. We have a good goal.
Ottawa on the power play. Carlson plays it across to Hoffman with Ryan standing in front. Here's Carlson with it. Brassard in the high slot. Now Turris the drive, scores! Kyle Turris, power play goal! And the game is tied at one. Just like that, 12 seconds into the power play.
You see the lack of reaction by Scott Darling as he's not able to track the puck as Ryan gets out of the way and creates that lane on the glove side, and we've got a tie game.
Jonathan Taves feeds it back for Keith. Back for Taves, winds in, drops it down. Kane with a chance. pulls it in behind the goal now, drops it back. Paddock scores! Paddock, a power play goal! And Chicago has retaken the lead.
Taves is going to kick it down to Patrick Kane. Now, Patrick Kane looking for options. He slides it right through the triangle of Dion Phaneuf to Panic, who fires it short side on Mike Condon. Tough for him to get across and seal the post.
Carlson fires it down. Darling reaching for it, can't get there. Time winding down. Kruger has it, banks it off the boards and back down the ice. And the Chicago Blackhawks will win it by a final score of 2-1 with a late power play goal by Richard Panic being the difference, as Ottawa fails to catch Montreal for top spot in the Atlantic Division, and Chicago extends its lead over Minnesota for top spot in the Western Conference.
Real strong game, a lot of chances. Both goaltenders played very well.